Students, we have been given two problems here to form the partial differential equations. The first problem is form the partial differential equation by eliminating the arbitrary constants from z is equal to ax plus by plus a square plus b square. And look into the equation, there are two arbitrary constants. We already know that when we have two arbitrary constants, to form the partial differential equation, we require at least three equations. To get the three equations, let the given equation be numbered as 1. So the given equation is taken as equation number 1. To get other two equations, let us go for differentiating the equation number 1 with respect to x, dou z by dou x is equal to, you take the first term ax, now we are differentiating with respect to x, a is a constant and differentiation of x with respect to x is 1. And going to the next term by, when we are differentiating with respect to x, all other variables are treated as constants. So b is a constant, y is also a constant, so the differentiation of a constant is equal to 0. And the third term, also it is a squared, it is a constant, the differentiation of constant is equal to 0. And the fourth term, b squared, it is also a constant, the differentiation of a constant is equal to 0. And from this, we can write that dou z by dou x, which is equal to p as per notation, which is equal to a. Now, let this be numbered as equation number 2. And we have to get the third equation to form the partial differential equation. For that, let us differentiate the given equation number 1 with respect to z. Dou z by dou y, which is equal to, for now, we are differentiating with respect to y. When we are differentiating with respect to y, all other variables are treated as constant. The first term is ax, a is a constant. When we differentiate with respect to y, x is treated as a constant. So ax is a constant, differentiation of a constant is equal to 0. The differentiation of first term is equal to 0. When you are coming to the next term, b is a constant. Now we are differentiating with respect to y. Differentiation of y with respect to y is 1. Now the third term is a squared. Differentiation of a squared, it is a constant, is 0. Similarly, the fourth term b squared, so it is also a constant. The differentiation of a constant is equal to 0. From this we get dou z by dou y is equal to, as per notation it is q, which is equal to b. This is numbered as equation number 3. Now our purpose is to obtain the partial differential equation. Now substitute 2 and 3 in 1, because we have got the equivalent terms for the arbitrary constants. Our purpose is to eliminate the arbitrary constants. For substituting the arbitrary constants, we can get the partial differential equation. Now substitute 2 and 3 in 1. Z is written as it is. Instead of A, we can write P, it is dou Z by dou X. Instead of B, we can write Q. It is P into X. Instead of B, we can write Q. Q into y. Instead of a squared, we can write p squared, and instead of b squared, we can write q squared. So it is the required partial differential equation. This is the required partial differential equation. Now in the second problem, form the partial differential equation by eliminating the arbitrary constants in z is equal to x minus a the whole squared plus y minus b the whole squared plus 1. And look into the equation, we have two arbitrary constants. As per our knowledge, if we have two arbitrary constants, we require at least three equations to form the partial differential equation. To get the three equations, let us take the given equation. To get other two equations, let us differentiate the given equation with respect to x. It is dou z by dou x equal to, now x minus a the whole squared is of the type function of a function. So you have to take x minus a as a whole, differentiate once, then differentiate the content in the bracket once. So it is x squared model x minus a 2 into x minus a. By differentiating the content in the bracket, the differentiation of x is 1, the differentiation of a is 0, plus y minus b the whole squared. When we are differentiating with respect to x, all other variables are treated as constants. Y is a constant, b is a constant, y minus b whole squared is a constant, differentiation of a constant is equal to 0, and the differentiation of 1 is also equal to 0. From this, p is dou z by dou x, it is written as p, which is 2 into x minus a. And from this, we can get an equivalent for x minus a. X minus a is equal to p by 2. Equal to p by 2. Let this be numbered as equation number 2. And to get the third equation, let us differentiate the given equation with respect to y. Dou z by dou y. It is, which is equal to x minus a the whole squared is a constant, because here we are differentiating with respect to y. X is a constant, a is a constant. So the differentiation of a constant, that is the first term, is equal to 0. And y minus b the whole squared, as we said already, it is taken as a function of a function type. Y minus b is taken as a single term like y. So it is 2 into y minus b, 2 into y minus b, the differentiation of y is 1, the differentiation of b is 0 when we differentiate the content of the bracket, and the differentiation of the third term, 1, is 0. From this we obtain dou z by dou y is q as per notation, which is equal to 2 into y minus b, 2 into y minus b, and from this we can obtain y minus b equal to q by 2. Now we have arrived terms for x minus a and y minus b. So this y minus b equal to q by 2 is taken as equation number 3. Now the constants are arrested in the brackets, so we have to eliminate the brackets as a whole. Now we have got terms for x minus a and y minus b. Substitute 2 and 3 in 1, we get z is equal to, instead of x minus a, we can substitute p by 2 the whole square, and instead of y minus b, we can substitute q by 2 the whole square plus 1. It is written as it is, and from this z is equal to p squared by 4 plus q squared by 4 plus 1, and taking LCM, 4 is at LCM and cross multiplying, 4 is at is equal to P square plus Q square plus 4 is the required partial differential equation. Now clearly understand how to eliminate the arbitrary constants.